Hello everyone. Topic is purchase. When we talk about purchase, purchase is used only for purchase of good in which the business deals. If we talk about a businessman, so if a businessman purchasing for the purpose of resale, so it is considered as a purchase. It means if you purchase assets, land, building, plant, machinery, so that is the investment, so that won't be recorded by the name of purchase. If we talk about manufacturing, if that firm is a manufacturing concern, then goods means acquiring raw material. Whatever raw material you are purchasing so that you can convert into finished goods. So that will be considered, that goods will be considered as a purchase. And the purpose of conversion into finished product and then sale. And if we talk about trading concern, so goods are those things which purchase for the resale. Like trading concern which purchase goods so that they can resell it, whatever goods they purchase for the purpose of resale. So that is considered as a purchase. But if anybody, any businessman purchase land, building, plant, machinery, so we won't consider it as a purchase. Next one is the purchase return. When purchase goods are returned to the supplier, like simple example, you purchase garments from any shop and you don't like it or any other reason you want to return it, just that particular garment is not fit. So in that case, that is considered as a purchase return. So whatever businessman in the same way, whatever businessman purchase for the purpose of resale, and if he find that particular good is not suitable, so he can return it. So that is considered as a purchase return. Next one is the sale. So sale means transfer of ownership of goods or service to customer. It means if I bought goods for the purpose of resale and I have sell to someone else, I sell to the customer and I have taken the money. So now I have the owner of that money and that customer will be the owner of that goods. So sale means transfer of ownership of goods or services to customer for a price. So that is called sale. It means in this transaction, transfer ownership will be transferred. It means I will be the owner of the cash and he will be the owner of the goods. So term sale is used only for the sale of those goods which are purchased for resale. In the same way, like when we talk about purchase, in the same way, sale is only used for the purpose of selling goods. It is not related to, like, you sold your land, building, plant, machinery, so that won't be considered as a sale. If any businessman sell only goods, so that will be considered as a sale. So sir, term sale is used only for the sale of those goods which are purchased for resale purpose. Sale is used only for the sale of those goods which are purchased for resale purpose. Now when we talk about sale return, so sale return means some customer, like you sold goods to any customer and if that person don't find it suitable for them or due to any reason he returned that goods, so that is considered as a sales return. It means whatever goods we sold to customer and if that customer returned that goods, so that is considered as a sale return, or that is also one more name is return involved. Now next one is the goods. So goods include all those things which are purchased for resale or which are used for producing the finished product, which are also meant to be sold. In goods, we will include all those things. It means, suppose you operate cosmetic shop. So in that case, whatever cosmetic product he is purchasing for the purpose of resale, so that will be considered as a goods. So which are used for producing the finished goods or which are also meant to be sold. Any flour mill owner purchase wheat for the purpose of preparing flour, so in that case wheat will be considered as a goods because he is using wheat so that he can convert it into flour. In the same way, like any as I have given an example, like cosmetic shop. If cosmetic shop is buying cosmetic material for the purpose of selling, so that is also considered as a goods for the cosmetic shop. Next one is the profit. It is the excess of total revenue over total expenses of business enterprise for an accounting period. So like if we talk about any company or any, like in the previous example, we can consider like cosmetic shop total income is 1 lakh rupees, and total expenses of that shop for particular month, that is 80,000. So if we deduct 1 lakh minus 80,000, so 20,000 will be profit of the company or firm. So that is considered as a profit. Next one is loss. If expenses more than revenue, then it is considered as a loss. If cosmetic shop expenses is 2 lakh and revenue is 1 lakh, so if we deduct expenses from revenue, so obviously your loss will be 1 lakh. It means if expenses more than revenue, then it is considered as a loss. So that is the one kind of loss. If expenses more than revenue, then it is considered as a loss. But second type is if firm perform any activity against which the firm receive no benefit. Like if we can take example, suppose you bought goods, that goods keep in godown, and somebody stolen that goods, so that is considered as a loss because you spend money on that but you won't get any benefit out of that. So that is considered as a loss by theft. So that is a second type. It means you perform activity but you won't get any benefit, so that is considered as a loss. Next one is the expenses. Expenses is cost incurred in producing and selling goods and services. It means whatever expenses you done of producing and selling goods, that is considered as a services, like cost of goods sold, rent, commission, etc. Whatever expenses you incurred, like producing, if you are like we can take example of flour mill owner. So obviously if he is converting raw material into finished goods, or he is converting wheat into flour, so obviously some expenses will be there. So that is considered as a expenses, like cost of goods sold, rent, commission. So that is considered as a expenses. It means you are spending money for producing or selling goods and services. So that these all expenses consider as a expenses. But when we talk about expenditure, so any disbursement of cash or transfer of property or incurring a liability for the purpose of acquiring assets, goods or services is called expenditure. If any businessman spend money or bought property, so obviously for like you bought property, so you have to spend money for the registry of that property. So whatever amount they have spent, so that is considered as a expenses. When we talk about expenditure, if any businessman is spending money for either acquiring for the goods or services, or acquiring for the assets, or for paying the liability, if any expenses any expenses paid by the businessman, so that is considered as a expenditure. We can categorize expenditure, capital expenditure, and revenue expenditure. That we will cover in the next video. Thank you.